kilometers of roads network the planet. Everywhere, new routes are being forged through increasingly difficult terrain. Across Arctic wilderness.
There's a dead chicken right there.
Over high mountain passes.
That's as big a drop as we've seen so far.
And through dense jungles.
Very good work.
These roads may be a testament to man's ingenuity, but driving on them requires skill.
I can't bear it.
Stamina.
Andy!
And a steady nerve. Comedian and broadcaster Sue Perkins is teaming up with actress and presenter Lisa Tarbuck to take on the Ho Chi Minh Trail, a road that became famous during the Vietnam War.
This is nuts!
Whoa!
Still littered with unexploded bombs, they will tackle the most remote and inaccessible parts of the trail.
I'm aware of UX being, so you know what I mean?
Yep.
Round that way, Sally.
The road will take them on rough jungle tracks.
Some of those are death falls this way.
Across raging rivers.
Right, yep, just keeping it right to the river.
And through swampy, sticky mud. Every mile hemmed in by tons of lethal explosives. 1,300 kilometers along one of the most infamous and perilous roads in the world.
This is dangerous, actually. Bombs are very near the road here.
Lisa and Sue know each other socially. They've never been in such close proximity as they will be over the next 10 days. They begin their journey in Vinh, a city that was completely obliterated by American bombing.
I guess what I really know about this area is what I've seen on television and possibly represented by Bollywood films.
I first met Lisa in Holloway Prison for Naughty Ladies. My budget is 6-year stretch, and she... yeah, she ruled the roost.
Welcome to our home. Am I intimidated by it? No, I don't think I am, actually. Neither Sue nor I are idiots.
I think it'll be a lot of fun. And she has the best breasts in show business. Amazing. Even better than Chris Moyle's. Best breasts.
Let's just do it. Let's get on the trail. I was really hoping she was going to drive.
The first hurdle is Vinh's rush hour traffic.
Go! Go! Go!
UK intent for you right there.
Now get behind this bike. It's going a nice steady pace.
Vietnam has a population of 80 million people and 40 million motorbikes. The result is traffic chaos and 30 road deaths every day. Not a fact that seems to faze the girls.
Good morning.
Here comes Susan!
Back off, pink hat!
King of the wrong man,
Trailer!
Sue and Lisa begin their journey in Vietnam before following the Ho Chi Minh Trail into Laos. They'll continue driving south, but the further they go, the worse the road conditions will become. The last stage of their journey will take them back over the border into Vietnam to finish on the beaches of the South China Sea.
It's a bit sort of 5 minutes out of the city, and there's just paddy fields. Too fast, and I actually ate my own breasts for a second.
Vietnam is one of the world's biggest exporters of rice. Every year, over $10 million worth goes to the USA.
How
do they feel about America? Have you got a bit of a clue on that? Is there a general feeling? I mean, you know, you wouldn't feel great.
But you know what? I don't think I would. If 40 years ago someone had really harmed London or any part of the UK.
Wow, we're still in living memory.
Well handled.
That was interesting.
Yes, wasn't it?
The Vietnam War between the communist North Vietnamese and the American-backed South Vietnamese lasted 19 years. It ended in 1975 with over 2 million dead, victory for the communist North, and defeat for the Americans. 2 hours down the road, Sue and Lisa are approaching Dong Lok, one of the main junctions on the Ho Chi Minh Trail. During the war, this was a target for American bombers. Today, it's a place of national pride and mourning.
Look at that. Lovely, lovely temple. He was going in a lick, wasn't he? This is a shrine, not a motorway.
A roadside stall is selling offerings for the remembered dead.
Please may I have one of these, or do I take two of these?
Let's take two, we'll have one each and burn them.
Okay.
Have a couple of these. Can you burn a mobile phone?
No, not particularly. I'd sooner do that in a sort of what I know kind of level. And perhaps some chrysanthemums.
So I guess this is where we burn our sparklers.
Hello.
You speak English?
Yes.
Hi there. We were wondering how we could, what we should do with all these things to be respectful.
Okay, so I'll show you.
So you pray and then you burn everything?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So we put the thing here.
Okay.
We put
everything on top.
Yeah.
Incense smells amazing.
This one is a flower, then pull on here.
So what does it say up there, please?
Yeah, it's the memory of the 10 women who died in the wartime.
Thousands of bombs were dropped on the road, but 30% of them failed to explode. It was the job of women to mark the unexploded bombs with flags, and in 1968, 10 young women were tragically killed here while trying to keep the road open.
So, some Westerners, it's quite odd that some of the things you burn are mobile phones and sunglasses. This is all because in the next life.
Because in an Asian country, we think that when you're leaving, what do you have? The people who die, they should have the same with you. So if you have a clothes, you will burn clothes for them. You have a car, you burn a car for them. You have a mobile phone, you burn the mobile phone for them.
I genuinely didn't know how to feel about that. It seems very, very alien. I felt like I didn't know what to do. And in that situation, I feel really disrespectful because I don't ever seem to be mocking it. And I'm not. It's culturally so kind of confusing to take up these sacks of fake money. And I didn't know the form. That's why all the worship is a bit confusing if it's not real thing.
Sorry, I cannot. Oh, man.
Yeah,
you're right.
Sorry.
Well done.
RSPCA that. I think that was slight education for all of us, no, including the pup. It's good though. I mean, driving here, your brain is fully left and right activated, isn't it? It's just, things just come out from the jungle either side.
Is there
buffalo, cats, dogs, farmers, all sorts.
The most remote and challenging sections of the road lie across the border in neighboring Laos, and that is where Sue and Lisa are now heading.
This is just heaven.
It's magic. It really is magic. So these clumps of limestone just kind of popped up. And then what's falling away in between them?
So limestone, you've got this fissure, so the rain gets in and it breaks it away in these sort of sheer faces.
The Trung Song mountain range forms a natural boundary between the two countries, and they have to climb up through heavily forested mountains to reach the border.
Amazing, and we've just gone like one mountain in, and it's already so visually different.
Yeah, you get a sense of what Laos is going to be like now.
During the war, the road was extended by the North Vietnamese into Laos. It became a vital route for arms and ammunition going south.
So this is the Laos border, and I'm officially by about 6-7 feet in another country. We left Vietnam, we had to change cars because you can't take those cars into this country. We'll use these until we get back down to the Vietnam border later on in the journey. I don't know what to expect for the next few days, but nobody said it's going to be easy.
Laos is a far poorer country than Vietnam, and it's immediately obvious from the condition of the roads.
It's just gone from a nice highway to sort of red dusty tracks. As soon as you go to the border, it changes.
I guess there isn't the money for it, is there?
At the border, the road is forced through a narrow gap in the mountains called the Mujia Pass. The road became so effective during the war that it was here in 1966 that the US launched the biggest bombing mission since World War II.
Marks in the rock up there. This feels probably like an adventure now.
I'm sort of so bewildered by the landscape. It's so beautiful, it's really hard to concentrate on the road, but the beauty is sort of so undercut by sadness all the time. It's so peaceful, you just hear the frogs and the crickets and the birds and nothing else. And just sitting in this landscape now, you'd have no clue that just a few decades ago, this was the most bombed place on Earth. That it was just a channel through which endless fighter planes dropped ordnance, that smashed into the rocks, that burnt all the foliage to nothing. So they even thought about nuking the whole place. Just a basin of horror. And the reason they were doing all this, and the reason they flew through this landscape is because of the aperture you can see in the distance. All the trucks, all the soldiers, everything had to go through that pass.
Morning rush hour on the Ho Chi Minh Trail. Sue and Lisa are now in a Buddhist country, and getting a blessing from a local monk is meant to ensure their safety on the road ahead.
Okay. Welcome to Laos. Do you know what? I felt really honoured about that. That was really lovely. I just didn't bank on getting quite as wet as I am.
In the coming days, they'll need all the help they can get. The Ho Chi Minh Trail has hundreds of river crossings, and Sue and Lisa are about to confront their first big one.
Right, so this looks like it might be quite fierce.
It does. So I've never crossed a river before in a car. This is going to be excellent. This is a mini Niagara going on.
What a
what's making me laugh is that this is like the shallow pool, and then you've got the deep pool there where the grown-ups are. Unless the water bottle has suddenly got this small,
yeah.
Right, I think you can do it.
No problem.
Look, he's doing it on the vine.
Victor's on a boat, look.
He's first, that's it. Right, good luck. Have a day.
That really strong current.
Yeah, you can do it. I know what I'm doing. I think I probably got a bit of sunstroke. I managed to get away with it apart from stops my ears. I actually am rocking quite a good look. I don't think I've ever looked this good. HOT doesn't even cover it. Hot doesn't even cover it. Look at those two, they look fabulous, don't they? Marvellous. Well, I like the look of this village.
These villages once bore the brunt of heavy bombing, and it's left them with some challenging recycling.
Suppose if I came across a load of bombs, I'd either run like a girl and or wee myself. I wouldn't think, here's an interior design opportunity, which seems to be what the people of Laos have done. It's kind of grand designs in a sort of military vein, because what they've done is they've taken all the ordnance they could find, once it's been defused, and they've just adapted it to improve their living conditions. So you've got cluster bombs here, which are providing shade. I've also seen some cluster bombs which have been used as stilts, so they're having a sort of support lending to the building. But everywhere you go, there's invention. You see the old use with things like this for your pig. You've got the feed for the pig, this big old boy here. I've got nothing for you, mate, I'm sorry. He's lovely looking, isn't he? Very handsome. And then up there, you've got some growing out of an old bomb.
The war ended nearly four decades ago, but there are still people in these villages that lived through it.
Mr. Pong, it's lovely to meet you, sir. Do you remember when you were a boy, when they started to use the Vietnamese started to use the Ho Chi Minh Trail?
พอมาทางเส้นตัวนี้ทางเส้นตัวนี้สมัยตะกี้แล้วมันน้อยเหมือนคืนนี้เวียดนามเราเอาอาวุธมันผ่านทางเส้นนี้ลงภาคใต้พุ่นผ่านทางเส้นโฮจิมินห์นี่แหละ
And how did the geography change? For example, we've got the mountains in the background, and I imagine that they were all changed with the bombing too.
ผู้ผ่าประตูนี้เปลี่ยนแต่ว่าไม่จะกลับคืนแล้วป่าไม้นี่สมัยตะกี้แล้วมันหิ้งนี่
There's very little land that's safe to farm, so people here risk collecting ordnance for scrap. Some even hoard live bombs beneath their homes. Since the war ended, 20,000 people in Laos have been killed by unexploded bombs. Even now, between 200 and 400 people, most of them children, lose their lives to UXBs every year. The roadside accommodation is proving to be interesting. It seems it's not just bed and breakfast that's on offer.
It looks like a brothel to me.
Yeah, it's a Christmas-themed brothel.
It's a grotto brothel.
Yeah.
Santa's own whorehouse.
Oh, look at that.
Brilliant.
Come on in.
Let's come on, let the fairy lights are up. The grog's on the go. The rice wine with the deer hoof is ready.
Come and brothel it up in here.
This part of Laos had no roads connecting the villages before the Ho Chi Minh Trail was built. Now the road is central to village life. Just days into their journey, Sue and Lisa seem to have settled into their respective roles.
Darling, I've done your washing. Would you like me to hang it out in the back of the car?
If you could.
Okay, I'm just doing some basic car mechanics, and then I wonder what I'd do is I'd sort of mitre off some wood.
Okay.
And just create some nice bench seat for us.
I'll have a
hairbrush. Yeah. Take care. It really doesn't work like that. Right, so for those people that don't know very much about a car engine, you've got your brake snake there, you've got a couple of litres of cola there. That's Wi-Fi there. Here's Lisa's drying her smalls in that.
Clearing Laos unexploded bombs didn't start until the 1990s, and today only a tiny fraction of its land has been made safe. Markers by the roadside are used to signify the level of risk, and red means danger.
This is dangerous, actually. The bombs are very near the road here. Which, of course, was the point, wasn't it?
Jesus Christ!
Please stay in the middle. In the middle.
4 decades later, some of the very people who tried to destroy the Ho Chi Minh Trail are returning to it.
Interesting, but they've come back, actually. So there's also something within them that, I don't know what they're, well, we'll find out, I guess, but well, they come back.
Well, I would.
Yeah, but do they come back because they feel guilty? But do they come back because they want to connect to their past, to them, because it makes it all right for them?
In the East, they do pilgrimages, don't they? And I think it's about that they need to put some things to bed.
Yeah.
And learn some things on the journey. And honour their chums.
Sue and Lisa have heard of 2 American veterans here to meet up with their old enemies. Roger Van Dyken and George Bukowski were part of the top secret Misty Squadron. Dedicated to disrupting supplies coming down the trail, they would fly low and fast to identify enemy targets. Almost a third of Misty pilots were shot down.
It's hard to use the term beauty when dealing with war, but it's been one of the, I can say, joys of now getting together with our former enemies, because we can both identify with the conflict, and nobody can quite understand like we understand one another. Even though we were on opposite sides, there's a common camaraderie that occurs quite quickly.
Because you're trained and you take orders and you don't question them, and you do, and there's a sense of national pride.
It's nothing personal, and that shows that both sides have gone a long way to forgive the hostilities that we had back then. And I feel like we bonded with several of these people that we fought to. It's just absolutely amazing. So if nothing else, we've made some progress here. It's certainly helped me.
Just one example of that down the road here, a U.S. airman was shot down. We met last night with the head of that 9-gun crew that shut him down. One member of that crew went to visit his son in the United States. While he was there, he went to Arlington National Cemetery and prayed at the grave of the person he shot dead.
And you met last night, and you can all talk about it.
Yep.
Right, so you feel for your own loss, you feel for their loss, and that's reciprocated.
Exactly. That's why slowly is a key word. You have to process that and come around to acknowledge we did terrible things to one another.
Yeah.
And at times we were terrible people in a terrible conflict. But now is the time to forgive one another and move on.
It's lovely to meet you both.
That's very, pleasure.
Thank you so much. It's a real pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just find it very emotional, I found.
Yeah, when
I found his insight really profound.
They're just kids when they were flying over here, and they've had the whole of their adult life has been spent dealing with what they did as kids. When I think of when I was their sort of age, I mean, I was just...
You're not doing the same, but different.
I was drinking 2 litres of cider on the top of a car park and crying about a boy called Richard. They were flying, you know, planes over Vietnamese mountains and rescuing their comrades. I mean, I still haven't got over Richard on some level, and they've managed to get over, sort of one of the worst conflicts of the 20th century.
Look at the butterflies, sir. It's just amazing.
Look at these guys, we're being followed by
butterflies!
There are hardly any other cars on the road, but many tractors called tuk-tuks are used to work the land and get people around.
Fucking racist.
Thank you.
Sue and Lisa have been on the road for nearly a week now, but they're not even halfway yet.
Stop annoying me.
Stop doing the spider on my
knee. Well, what's a shame is that they've got two women in a car and all they've done is bicker.
You know I'm ticklish on my knee and all you do is you try and
get spider on the knee.
I am trying to put it into fourth.
What, by doing that? Who changes gear like that? Weirdo.
Road, it's like driving on cocoa powder.
Now we have another little turn. Do you think it's down and round, or do you think it's straight on? That's very powdery there, whereas that looks more compacted. There's a few cobbles there, so there you go.
That's good work, Perky.
Are there cobbles there?
Yeah.
Hello. I think, 12-point turn here. We'll be able to do it.
If you have to turn your car around on this road, there's no margin for error.
So, very uncomfortable.
With what?
At these turns.
Well, because of the UXBs.
Well, yeah, actually, because I think there's a level of slack that comes in as you get used to it. And all the trees around here have got red lines on them saying, don't come in. I realise...
There's just nowhere to turn.
No, what can you do? I can tell you what, they're really draining to do as well when it's sort of... faithful little dog and all that. What's intrigued me there is...
It's woman's work.
No, it's a little bit near the bleeding road.
Yeah.
And there's no markers.
Zabadi!
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 The average wage in Laos is just $3 a day, so some people risk searching through danger zones with metal detectors to make a living.
And this is a metal detector. Are you looking for explosives and bombs, or are you just looking for metal? Do you worry that this work is very dangerous? Have you heard of people being injured doing your work and hurt and killed? Could we look in your basket and see what you've managed to find today?
Thank you.
You're steady too then.
Yeah, interesting. We've got this kind of thing here.
And this is the fin of a cluster bomb, which they jokingly call a pineapple. When you start to dig, how do you know whether it's a bit of an old motorcycle or whether it's a bomb? And how much money do you make to do this job? Do you mind telling us how old you are? Do you know how old you are? I wish you all the safety. Be very careful.
Thank you very much.
And thank you. It's really good to speak to you. Thank you.
I was just astounded they didn't know how old they were, because of course that's not really that relevant. It's sort of surplus to requirement. Birthdays and all that. Just crack on, get on with it. There's more important things to do, like finding where the next meal's coming from.
Ooh, what's this?
Golden Anaphores.
Oh my goodness, that's a blooming interesting bridge, isn't it?
That's great.
That's fantastic.
It's a timber piled up.
Oh, that's impressive, isn't it?
Yeah. Look, it looks like there was a bridge there, but it's collapsed.
Interesting as well is doing it in a 4x4 with modern day suspension, allegedly, that would probably be knackered. But if you were in trucks, army trucks, bikes, or on foot, and still you're managing to get everything where it's meant to be. And it's a nice road.
Very.
So,
we need a mine.
Yeah, I'd have thought.
This is money.
There's money in this
road. This
road
is the yellow brick road.
There's gold in them there hills.
Sue and Lisa are approaching the Sepon gold and copper mine. The existing road can't cope with the number of huge lorries accessing the mine. But before any work can begin to widen the road, the land must be cleared of unexploded bombs. Magnus Ahlstrom and his team have been called in.
You want us to follow you into a site where there are possible unexploded ordnance now?
You would walk on cleared area all the time.
Yeah.
But the surroundings, they can be...
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
So we basically stick to the path, follow you guys.
Yes.
Do not deviate, yeah. Otherwise trouble. Do we get to wear a hat?
Yeah, sure.
I won't be going to have a look at the Danger UXB. It's a funny old thing, and call me a wuss if you want to. But as we were coming through the pass, it's the first time we had any juice on our phones, and suddenly a waft of texts, etc., came through. I got 11. Three or four of which all said to me from different mates, I hope you're not taking any unnecessary risks. And then I've been presented with one, which, because we're on a roll and we're on a big story and we've been going war,
This is a magnificent thing to follow up, and you know how wonderful that people are doing it. I'm a pansy blooming presenter broadcaster from England. I'm not Ross Kemp.
We were going for the safety chat, and I was a bit gung-ho because I thought, ooh, steel cap boots and high-vis jacket and all that sort of stuff. Got me quite sort of, pumped up. And then Magnus off camera just pointed out that there are two unexploded 750-pound bombs within 100 metres of here. And suddenly the bravado has really gone, and I just look like, you know, somebody who auditioned for the Village People and didn't quite make the grade. So, yeah, I mean, genuinely really... really queasy, plus the fact that, you know, Lisa's very perceptive, and when she says, this is dangerous, I kind of hear it, and I sort of part of me thinks, why am I doing this? What am I trying to prove to myself or to everybody else? And yet here I am. So we'll see, I guess.
Please hold on to the fence,
huh? Yeah, no, I'm not gonna mess around. Not overly convinced by the construction of that fence.
Stay away from the edge.
So how many pounds is this one?
750.
When you're working with a bomb, what kind of safety equipment do you have?
None. Helmet and boots.
Because there's no equipment in the world,
nah,
I guess that will stop.
Won't help you.
You just... you vaporise, presumably.
Yeah. You're going to become dust.
So your hat, ironically, your hat and your boots would be all that would probably remain from...
No, not even that.
So it vaporised rubber and steel toe caps, everything. So say you have to do a controlled explosion. What's the procedure for that?
Yeah, we have to move all living creatures in a surrounding about 1,000 metres away from here and block roads. I have to direct the blast because the pressure is going out somewhere, so I would probably go in the bush here and down to the river. We need to seal off the river as well, so there's going to be boats or anything. Airplanes.
Good.
I go over there and put some C4 on it and a cable. They move away.
And then?
Bang. And you will hear if it goes bang.
You've worked all around the world in all the major sort of trouble spots of the world. Have you found that this has been the most...
Yeah, this is the most bomb place on the planet.
And how long do you estimate it would take to clear Laos?
We would probably need like 1 million people or something.
And how long would 1 million people take?
Oh, man.
A lifetime?
Yeah.
So why do you think this particular point in the Ho Chi Minh Trail took so much ordnance?
Yes, here is because it's a river crossing.
Okay.
And you just smash the bridges.
Really close to the road. That sort of gives me pause for thought because we're driving that road and there's this huge bomb just yay far from it. It's easy when you're doing long distances just to be quite cavalier and not to think it's dangerous.
Yeah.
Because it's hidden, everything is hidden.
Yeah, they're just everywhere. Expect the unexpected.
Thank you, Magnus. Right, much as it's been an education, it's not my natural habitat, so I'm going to, I don't know, go and go somewhere a bit more ladylike.
Yeah.
Is this way? Is this a good way or that way?
No, don't go in there. You follow the road down here.
I've never been on a trip that's made me feel so conflicted and so brain-fugged because sort of half of me is all about, it's just, my mind is sort of filled with war and destruction and sort of fear and... disbelief that this beautiful landscape superficially kind of draws you in with its gorgeousness, but it's just rotten with toxins and, you know, shrapnel and ordnance underneath. And the other part of me is trying to be a bit more Southeast Asian and a little less me, actually, and trying to say, well, you can dwell on that, or you can just look at what the guys are doing here, piece by piece, you know, clod of clay by clod of clay, trying to make it better. So, Magnus was quite a sex bomb. Everyone pretty much within 100 metres of his blast radius was pretty much sucked in.
Were you sucked in, Sid?
I was a bit, in a sense that I thought, and I'm ashamed to say this to you, but I just want to lie my head next to you just for the evening, because I'd feel safe there. Look at that!
Oh,
let's just enjoy. enjoy that.
That is beautiful.
Let's just look at the scene and think this is the most beautiful place.
Ladylike country, buggered by war.
Sue and Lisa now face one of the most challenging sections of the road. 400 kilometers of jungle, dirt tracks and river crossings from the Sepon mine down to the Vietnam border. But first, they have a big river to cross.
The thing is with this river crossing is if it all goes horribly, horribly wrong, at least we'll be spared another night in a brothel.
Where is that?
I mean, this apartment would rather be washed downstream than have to have another night's accommodation like last night. Oh yeah, that's doable.
They've been told that vehicles do cross the river here, but they need to take a closer look before risking it.
Because once you've negotiated the fallen trees, UXOs, rocks, I don't think there's going to be much of a problem. This is shite. It's one. And then it gets really deep there. Oh god, yeah. Really deep there. There is no way we'll get over there without stalling. The thing is not knowing what's in the middle of it.
Yeah, exactly.
So I'm going to go Cuban dipstick and see how deep it is.
Lovely.
That's nice. Oh man, there's some very odd rocks here. That's good. This was in my contract. I said, whatever you do, make sure there's a calendar opportunity. This is Sue. She's April. She's 42. These are her own breasts, as you can tell from the natural sag. What's the depth like? What do you think it's like? Because the dipstick is up to here.
I think I'm going to drive it. I'm not.
Why do you think I've gone in here?
Despite the bravado, the girls have to consider another option. Failing to get across here could mean losing the car and risking the whole trip.
I understand we're in 4x4, but I mean, I'm slipping all over the shop, and there's this huge patch where there's just nothing. And the thing is, however exciting it might be for a millisecond, the idea of the car actually filling with water.
It's not exciting.
It's not good. We should check out this other river crossing.
There's a dip forwards this way, so I suppose we're going to the right spot.
Of course we are. Well, there's the river. It doesn't look as bad as the other one, does it?
Yeah. Start this. Nicely done, nicely done.
Across the Thames like that. I've had enough of the underground. Let's just go north or south.
We'll go that way.
I mean, discuss the fact that we're probably leaking quite a lot of fuel.
Oh, this is a bit tricky, actually.
We're going to shear.
Yeah, this is a bit tricky. Stop.
Let me have a look.
Go down further to the left.
Wait just a minute, madam.
Defo leftish.
Oh, I've left my effing brolly. Yeah,
I want you. Whoa, right up. Bit more. That's looking pretty good. Just come forward a bit so you can get that spot on. And then it's a...
We're probably going to have to go up on that boulder though, because I think that boulder's too high for us to...
No, you'll just make it. You just need to skirt that. There is enough room. Can you do it?
Yeah, fine to do it. So I'm going either side of it, you mean?
No, now I'm going
this way. So yeah. Right of the boulder.
Don't go too right, because you don't want... That's when your steering will flip out of your control. Right the steering wheel. That's it. Right the steering wheel. Keep the steering wheel straight. And now... Round that way, Sally.
Right. God. I couldn't see where the road was, so I thought we were going up there, because I'm a fucking idiot. Anyway, let's get back a bit. That's good. That's okay.
Good work. Very good work.
Even on this mud track, any deviation carries a huge risk. Along this remote part of the trail, only a tiny fraction of the surrounding land has been cleared of unexploded bombs.
Not that track, please.
No. Well, I'm just, you know...
I'm aware of UX being, so you know what I mean?
Yep, it's so... So am I. I'm not going to try and kill you.
After 6 hours picking her way across some of the trail's toughest sections, Sue's had enough.
Okay, can I stop driving?
Yeah.
Sue and Lisa are on the most remote part of the trail. Very few people come this way, and Westerners are a real rarity. It's been a hard slog, and the girls decide to take a quick break.
We might chomp on a few hot nuts.
Hung nuts?
Uh-oh. What? Abnormal.
It's all yellow.
Hello, boy.
Hi, darling.
Zabadee.
Got some nuts?
Any news?
Right, scared by your massive knife, but I'll give you some peanuts. I'm hoping you won't use it.
Yeah, put it away.
There you go, sweetheart.
Really?
That's great. Love the look of you. I know a few people would kill for a chest like you. Lovely, lovely chest. Lovely musculature. Very pretty. I can see you are ogling my jugs as well.
Yeah, he's having a right good look at yours.
What have you got in there? What's in there? Can I have a look in there? In here? It's basically intestines, isn't it? So do I think... Maybe chicken. Actually, it might be chicken. Is it...
Yeah?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Which could mean...
Yeah, they meant
yeah. See you later then, lads. Bye then.
Bye. They were both really beautiful.
Right. Bottom of this poor thing.
I look like an expendable crew member in Star Trek. I just ate the ceiling of the car.
No, it's not over yet, Susan.
Yeah, they've requested at their funeral that Slip Sliding Away be played.
You know the near your destination, Slip Sliding Away.
Oh, that's a bit annoying.
You start.
Yeah. I'm gonna go push. Right.
Britain's weakest woman is on push duty. I'm gonna reverse! That really smells bad. This is the only occasion where I've ever thought we might need Jeremy Clarkson. Why have you mentioned him? The problem we've got is there's no grip in the tyres because they're all absolutely ram-packed full of the clay. Yeah.
Even on the road, there is real danger. Churning up mud on the track can be lethal as bombs are only cleared down to a depth of 50 centimetres.
So I don't want to touch anything from the side in case 500 bombies fall down. Rev, rev, rev.
It'll be dark in less than an hour. If they don't want to spend the night in the jungle, they must get moving.
We're getting more traction. Yeah, I'm gonna be alright, just... flat out on the accelerator, that.
There we go.
Well, I tell you, it just makes a mockery of all the lovely ladies taking their kids to school in a 4x4.
All rich people driving Chelsea tractors should be made to do the Ho Chi Minh Trail before they're allowed to have
one. They're even allowed.
All those precious yummy mummies.
Delightful people at all.
Where did they come from?
Hey!
Brilliant kids, brilliant kids.
Look at them licking it!
Daddy, Daddy!
Oh, that's Daddy! Daddy! That's Daddy! Daddy!
Eventually they make it through and link up with one of Laos' brand new highways. This is one of several massive road-building projects that connects Laos with Thailand, Cambodia, and Vietnam. On the final leg of Sue and Lisa's journey, they hope to make it out of Laos and back over the border into Vietnam. Da Nang and the beaches of the South China Sea will mark the end of their journey. The girls are determined to make it in one day, so they're up early.
At the moment, it's looking like we might have to go to the beach. We love that one.
Are we nearly there yet?
The first part of today's journey takes them through a part of Laos that was once dense forest.
Ooh, look at these big boys. Logging, logging, logging. Oh, that's interesting, boys. Those beautiful trees.
To get to the border, they're going to have to compete with heavily loaded logging trucks hauling hardwood into Vietnam.
That lorry could topple over there.
Gosh, I don't want to see that, thank you.
I think it's going to be a log sandwich in a minute. Okay, burn this. We just hit the logging trail. And I let the arm legs show us how it's done on a blind bend. Good God. Oh dear, that doesn't look good at all. And it's right next to a slightly smoky. Oh God, it looks like a fatality to me. Just when you get blasé, you get just a sobering reminder like that upturned logging truck. Just, it's not worth pushing it. Look at this magnificence! Just rolling forest. It's just so glam in the eye. Beautiful! I'm going to have the best wee ever at the border. Right on the border, though, because they tend to take offence at that. I think that was one of the do's and don'ts, wasn't it? Don't urinate at the border.
The girls are forced to stop at the border, but they are both keen to get moving if they're going to make it to the coast today.
It's going to be faster and noisier once we're on the road there. I'm going to get horny. As soon as I pass that, I'm bipping that thing. Anything coming at me, whether it be livestock or a massive great logging truck, I'm going to horn the hell out of it. This is ridiculous, isn't it? It's deserted. I've never seen... This is like the M25, but with nobody on it. And not nobody on it for miles, as far as the eye can see. So who's it for? Is it just those little girl we're communists that will hear us roar?
This is the new Ho Chi Minh Highway, built on top of the original trail. Just 15 years ago, this area was also pristine forest, but it's been stripped of its timber, and now coffee, tea, and rubber grow here.
Do you really think I'm a bad driver? No, because I wouldn't have done this with the fruit.
Are you calling a fruit?
You bloody fruit. What are you calling a fruit? I could have you. I could take your truck to a tribunal for that. That's what you want, Smith. That's what you... You're just trying to get me into your lair.
Sue me, what can you do me? I love you.
All right, well, that's on camera now, so there's certain things...
A song from a film.
What's she doing? This guy is absolutely stupid as all hell. Right up the side there, I'm gonna open the blooming door on him if he keeps it up. I've got a Vietnamese driving license, have you?
Oh, I'm showing.
This suit's a real blood thug, isn't it? It's, I was hoping for a bit of art, you know what I mean? He's gonna think, oh, it'll be all easy now, we've got a nice little run into the beach.
Silly, have we had?
As the light fades, Sue and Lisa are still miles from the beach, their hotel, and the end of their journey.
Not another bus in the road. Thousands of miles!
150,000 miles an hour.
So, I mean, we're both taking an absolute pounding. It's just...
It's like you get with pinball with the cars and livestock and buses just randomly flying in all kinds of directions and you just have to try and
you need a new one just when you think, well, surely I've reached the next level. I'll tell you, what's this with full beams on?
Christ almighty, they are willing you to fail at all times, drivers here, aren't they?
Oi, my god! Single file, darling! And your buffalo! Oh, baby, 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 careful.
Oh. It doesn't even come about preserving your own life. Just desperate tension about not wanting to kill anything else.
Is he drunk? Or has he got...
Kid on the back!
Oh, god! Oh,
Jesus!
What are you doing? We've got three kids, just, oh my god, the others, 14 driving that bike?
Finally, after 10 grueling days, Sue and Lisa reach sanctuary and the end of their Ho Chi Minh adventure.
We've gone from dirt tracks and indigenous peoples, we've gone from scantily clad men with machetes and baskets of chicken guts staring at our boobs to
the mellow surroundings where everyone's dressed in pastels and asks you if you're okay and would you like a shiatsu?
Come on, Perkins!
I've absolutely loved it, and I think that every single bit of it has been important, good and bad. We actually journeyed through history. We got to bump along the same tracks that trucks bumped along 40 years ago.
Got very tired of talking about the war because it was sort of contradictory to what we were actually witnessing, which is an extraordinary recovery by extraordinary people, be it in Vietnam or be it in Laos.
Lisa drove me utterly, utterly insane. We had a real laugh, and I couldn't have wished for a better person to do it with.
But Sue is fabulous, and I drove her potty. I told her, I'm going to drive you mad. I don't know how or when or for how long, but I will drive you mad.
I had a wonderful time. It wasn't the wonderful time I thought I was going to have, but it so far exceeded that in its depth and its range and its character and its memories that I, you know, I feel really blessed, actually, really, really, truly blessed.
Next here on BBC HD, there are some things you need to know about the human body with James May.